Following yet another mass shooting in the United States this past weekend, Republican Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene took to Twitter, as pretty much every politician did, to condemn the actions that took place that day and to extend their heartfelt sympathies towards the victims and their families. But what Marjorie Taylor Greene did was basically blame everything for this last shooting, except, of course, for the thing responsible, which is guns. According to reports, the shooter was, quote, armed to the teeth with weapons when they killed 8 people, injured more than half a dozen more, traumatized God knows how many, at a Texas outlet mall. And here is what Marjorie Taylor Greene had to say. Thank God for the brave officer that courageously ran into the line of fire to save others. We pray for the victims and their families and an end to the mental illness, drugs, and evil forces that cause people to commit such horrors. Mental illness, drugs, and evil forces. That's what's responsible for what happened this past weekend. It's not the fact that the shooter was, again, as the report said, armed to the teeth. No, 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 no. It's not the fact that just a couple years ago, Greg Abbott, the governor of Texas, encouraged people to buy guns because, you know, Texas had fallen to number 2 in new gun sales. So he got on Twitter and said, make sure you buy more guns. No, no, no. It's not the guns, folks. It's just evil throughout this country. It's mental illness. It's drugs. Now, here's the other part of this. Marjorie, if you actually believed it was any one of those 3 things, or even all 3 of those things, it's important to note you're also not doing anything about that shit either, are you? Like, where's your legislation mandating mental wellness checks for people who want to buy guns? Where's your legislation mandating free mental health care for all Americans, right? I mean, if you think it's a mental health crisis, then we should be addressing the mental health aspect of it, but we're not doing that either. Oh, it's the drugs. What are you doing about drugs? Where's your legislation? Let me see that. It's evil. Okay, well, evil is a concept and you cannot legislate morality. But one thing you can do is you can prevent mentally unwell people from getting their hands on guns. You can prevent drug addicts from getting their hands on guns. And you can prevent evil people from getting their hands on guns that can kill 60 people in under a minute. That is something we can do as a country. That is something that a majority of people in this country want to see happen. Marjorie Taylor Greene and her Republican acolytes in the Senate and the House are on the minority side here. We, the responsible, common sense people, we are the majority. As I have repeatedly said, the only place where you are going to see disagreement about reining in gun violence in the United States is in Congress. State Congress, federal Congress. Those are the only places where there's disagreement about whether or not we should even do something. You go ask the average American citizen, they're going to tell you, hell yeah, we should do something. Even Fox News, by the way, called out Greg Abbott and pointed out this past weekend that a majority of people in this country support common sense gun control. If we're at the point where even Fox News is having to correct Republicans and be like, listen, most people want this stuff off the streets, then maybe we've turned a corner. Maybe we're approaching that number where enough people have died that even some conservatives are starting to wake up and realize that this is no way for us to go through life. We shouldn't have to fear that if we go to the mall, we're not going to come home. We shouldn't have to fear dropping our kids off at school because they may not make it home. We shouldn't be afraid to go to the grocery store or to church or to a synagogue or a mosque or a concert. But we are. And the reason we're afraid of that is not because of evil. It's not because of mental illness or drugs. It's because of the easy access to guns that dangerous people in this country have. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos. So do us a favor and subscribe.